The two main components of the oral mucosa are the stratified squamous epithelium and the underlying connective tissue called the lamina propria. The epithelium is of two types, the keratinized and the non-keratinized epithelium. While the gingival and the palatal mucosa are keratinized, the non-keratinized epithelium lines the rest of the oral mucosa. Below the epithelium is the lamina propria or the connective tissue. And for descriptive purposes, the lamina propria is divided into a papillary layer associated with the epithelial ridges and a reticular layer below it. So how does the epithelium sit on the connective tissue without ripping apart? Well, one reason is that the epithelial connective tissue interface is not flat. The interface is rather undulating or wavy, in which the connective tissue papillae interlock with the epithelial ridges. In fact, scanning electron micrographs show that connective tissue has numerous conical papillae jutting out and penetrating the epithelium, thus giving it a firm attachment. Now that being said, the interlocking alone does not provide for a firm attachment. It has to be understood that the basal cells of the epithelium do not sit directly on the connective tissue, but is rather attached to it with the help of intercellular junctions called hemidesmosomes, which lie on a structure called the basal lamina. In the light microscope, when the tissue is stained with a special stain called periodic acid skiff, the basement membrane can be visualized as a thin line between the epithelium and the connective tissue. This basement membrane at the ultrastructural level is called the basal lamina and consists of two layers called lamina lucida and lamina densa. The basal lamina consists of proteins making the hemidesmosomal junctions. Now, hemidesmosomes are composed primarily of three proteins, the transmembrane proteins, the cytoplasmic adapter proteins, and the cytoskeletal filaments. Bullous pemphigoid antigen 180 or BP180 and alpha-6 beta-4 integrins form the transmembrane proteins. BP230 and plectin form the cytoplasmic adapter proteins, and tonofilaments or cytokeratins form the cytoskeletal proteins. Together, these proteins, along with other constituents of the basal lamina like laminin and type 7 collagen, otherwise called as anchoring fibrils, help in the firm attachment of the epithelium to the connective tissue.